It's Liv, and today we're going to learn about tracks with Biology in a Box. This is Unit 7, Exercise 1A. Every species has unique and different feet. And when they travel, they leave behind tracks, otherwise known as footprints. As you complete the following exercise, I want you to think about what more we could learn from these tracks. The purpose of this exercise is to match the animal tracks with the animal that put them there. It is best for age groups kindergarten through first grade. For this exercise, you will need a track identification sheet, which shows the tracks, a picture of the animal, and the name. You will also need the tracks A through R, starting with A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, and last but not least, R. The instructions on how to do this activity are choose one of the identification sheets. Find the animal track that matches the one on the page. To do this, you need to examine the picture, read the name, and look at the tracks. Once you've found a match, repeat these steps for all animal tracks. So earlier, I asked how we could tell more about the tracks. So, from the footprint, you can also learn how long ago the track was made. By as a track ages, its edges become less sharp. This, of course, is affected by the weather. You can also learn how big the animal was. The heavier the animal, the deeper the print. The larger the animal, the larger the print. Also, depth is affected by how soft the ground was at the time the footprint was made. You can also determine how fast the animal was going by the spacing between each footprint. If you follow the tracks, chances are you can find the animal and where it was leading to, and where its home is at. And remember, what all we can learn from just a footprint. Bye!